The Stolen Bride. About the year 1670, there was a fine young fellow living at a place called Kirin in the County Clare. He was brave and strong and rich, for he had his own land and his own house, and not one to lord it over him. He was called the Kern of Kirin, and many a time he would go out alone to shoot the wild fowl at night along the lonely strand, and sometimes cross over northward to the broad east strand, about 2 miles away, to find the wild geese. One cold, frosty November eve, he was watching for them, crouched down behind the ruins of an old hut, when a loud splashing noise attracted his attention. "It is the wild geese," he thought, and raising his gun, waited in death-like silence the approach of his victims. But presently, he saw a dark mass moving along the edge of the strand, and he knew there were no wild geese near him. So he watched and waited till the black mass came closer, and then he distinctly perceived 4 stout men carrying a bier on their shoulders, on which lay a corpse covered with a white cloth. For a few moments they laid it down, apparently to rest themselves, and the kern instantly fired, on which the 4 men ran away shrieking, and the corpse was left alone on the bier. Kern of Kirin immediately sprang to the place, and lifting the cloth from the face of the corpse, beheld by the freezing starlight the form of a beautiful young girl, apparently not dead, but in a deep sleep. Gently he passed his hand over her face and raised her up. When she opened her eyes and looked around with wild wonder, but spake never a word, though he tried to soothe and encourage her. Then, thinking it was dangerous for them to remain in that place, he raised her from the bier, and taking her hand, led her away to his own house. They arrived safely, but in silence, and for 12 months did she remain with the kern, never tasting food or speaking word for all that time. When the next November eve came round, he resolved to visit the east strand again, and watch from the same place in the hope of meeting with some adventure that might throw light on the history of the beautiful girl. His way lay beside the old ruined fort called the Fort of the Mantle, and as he passed, the sound of music and mirth fell on his ear. He stopped to catch the words of the voices, and had not waited long when he heard a man say in a low whisper, "Where shall we go tonight to carry off a bride?" And a second voice answered, "Wherever we go, I hope better luck will be ours than we had this day 12 months. "Yes," said a third, "on that night we carried off a rich prize, the fair daughter of O'Connor. But that clown, the Kern of Kirin, broke our spell and took her from us. Yet little pleasure has he had of his bride, for she has neither eaten nor drank nor uttered a word since she entered his house." "And so she will remain," said a fourth, "until he makes her eat off her father's tablecloth, which covered her as she lay on the bier, and which is now thrown up over the top of her bed." On hearing all this, the kern rushed home, and without waiting even for the morning, entered the young girl's room, took down the tablecloth, spread it on the table, laid meat and drink thereon, and led her to it. "Drink," he said, "that speech may come to you." And she drank, and eat off the food, and then speech came. And she told the kern of her story, how she was to have been married to a young lord of her own country, and the wedding guests had all assembled, when she felt herself suddenly ill, and swooned away, and never knew more of what had happened to her until the kern had passed his hand over her face, by which she recovered consciousness, but could neither eat nor speak, for a spell was on her and she was helpless. Then the kern prepared a chariot and carried home the young girl to her father, who was like to die for joy when he beheld her. And the kern grew mightily in O'Connor's favor, so that, at last, he gave him his fair young daughter to wife, and the wedded pair lived together happily for many long years after, and no evil befell them, but good followed all the work of their hands. This story of Kern of Karen still lingers in the faithful, vivid Irish memory, and is often told by the peasants of Clare when they gather round a fire on the awful festival of Samhain or November Eve, when the dead walk, and the spirits of earth and air have power over mortals, whether for good or evil.